Edwin Carter's life was as intriguing and mystifying as his legacy has now become. Few men throughout history have managed to capture the intrigue and curiosity of so many during their time, yet leave behind a life story that begs more questions than can be answered. Perhaps the most perplexing was his decision to abandon the very profitable enterprise of gold mining to pursue a career in taxidermy and wildlife preservation, transforming what was once merely a hobby into a lifelong passion. Edwin Carter's Log Cabin Museum, built by Carter himself in 1875, housed one of the most impressive and extensive collections of wildlife ever amassed by a single person. The cabin's unique 12-foot-high ceilings provided ample space to exhibit some of his larger specimens. His collection, including some now extinct species, helped make possible the creation of the Denver Museum of Nature and Science. It has brought the untamed and, in many cases, previously unseen animal kingdom face to face with tourists and travelers for well over a century. Yet we know remarkably little about the man himself. His death on February 3, 1900, and the days that followed were, ironically, the most documented in Carter's life. Edwin Carter was posthumously honored as first private citizen of Colorado. His body lay in state at the Colorado State Capitol Building for public viewing, an honor normally reserved for leading statesmen and dignitaries. On a frigid winter day, his body was taken by train over the 11,500-foot-high Boreas Pass to the small town of Breckenridge. For two more days, he lay in state as hundreds of mourners, led by the Freemasons, paid their last respects. It is clear Edwin Carter had become an integral figure in Colorado society. But how and why he was able to achieve this is still somewhat of a mystery. What may have helped mold this man from a New York-born hunter to a symbol of environmental conservation? His life story has been eclipsed by history. His life's work, however, has become an enduring legacy.